Hi viewers, welcome to the first video of our genetic resources and conservation from MH Biology. In this session of lectures, a series of lectures, we will study about the subject genetic resources and conservation. Our first lecture is on genetic resources. So what are the genetic resources? Genetic resources is any genetic material which is of actual or potential value. So if we see any genetic material, so it's any genetic material or the material of heredity from the plant, animal, microbial or any other origins or from any living organism. So in a short, we can say that genetic resources is any genes that are of beneficial characteristics that encodes for beneficial that have some benefit for the mankind or for the ecosystems. So the genetic resources can include animal genetic resources and the plant genetic resources. Other than this, microbial genetic resources, aquatic genetic resources, these all are different types of genetic resources. So in the genetic resources, our main focus is on the genetic material or the genes or any part of the genetic material that is of actual or potential value that is of our benefit. So in the animal genetic resources, this can include all the breeds and all the species of the animals that the humans can use or that are beneficial for food or for agriculture production. And in case of a plant genetic resources, the plant genetic resources include all the cultivars of the plants or the varieties of the plants that are beneficial for us, that we can use as food, or that we can use like wood for making the buildings and some other purposes. So the genetic resources are any genetic material that is of potential or actual value. So what does using genetic resources mean? Genetic resources means, the using genetic resources mean that it is a process of researching for beneficial characteristics of genetic resources and using them, or using those beneficial characteristics, or using those genetic resources for increasing the scientific knowledge, for our understanding of the natural world, and for developing some commercial products. So when we see that what using the genetic resources mean, it means that it is a process for searching the beneficial properties of genetic resources that we can use to increase our scientific knowledge, that we can use to understand the living world, or that we can use to make some commercial products. So why genetic resources are useful? The genetic resources, first of all, they help us to understand the living world, like how these species or different breeds, they are working, what are their beneficial characteristics, and how they can benefit the other animals or other species. The second is the development of new products for well-being of humans. So we can use these genetic resources to make the new products, like we can make we can make the disease-resistant plants, or we can make the animals with some good food and good nutritious food. The third one is improved conservation methods that help to safeguard global biodiversity. The knowledge of genetic resources will also help us to design the conservation methods that will help us to conserve the biodiversity. Once the biodiversity will be conserved, it means that our ecosystems, they are more protected, our ecosystems, they are well maintained, and they are more balanced, and it will lead towards a good healthy environment, because all the species, they are playing very important role in the environment. So when we talk about uses of the genetic resources, with the development of modern biotechnology, with the development of genetic engineering and other techniques, genetic resources have expanded their uses. Now we can, on a broader scale, we can say that we can use the genetic resources for the commercial purposes or for non-commercial purposes. First of all, we see the commercial uses of genetic resources. For the commercial uses of genetic resources, we can use the genetic information, or we can use the genetic material to for the production of for the production of enzymes, and we can enhance the genes and other small molecules for increasing their use in the industries. And we can enhance the genes to make good plants and animals with some good characteristics. And we can use these enzymes or enhance genes in the crop protection, drug development, and industrial processes. First of all, if we see the commercial uses of genetic resources in the biopharmaceutical industry, in the biopharmaceutical industry, the commercial the genetic resources can be used for the production of the drugs. We can modify the genes, and we can use the genes that are encoding for some beneficial protein, which can be used as a drug. We can use that gene and we can get the drug. Similarly, we can use the plants, because there are several drugs that are extracted from the plants, and we can use the plants as a sources for those drugs. Similarly, the genetic resources can be used for the industrial processes. We can get the enzymes from bacteria, and these enzymes can be used in several industrial processes, like in the textile industry and food industry, some other chemicals that can be extracted from these natural resources. They can be used for preservation of the food, and similarly for the crop in the agriculture industry. We can enhance the characteristics of the crop. We can make a disease resistant crop, and similarly we can change, or we can modify the genes, or we can even insert some new genes in the plants, and in this way the plants will be more disease resistant, and their production can be increased, their well-being can be increased, and which will ultimately lead to the well-being of the humans, or which will ultimately increase or improve the economy of the country. And other than this, the genetic resources can also be used commercially for the horticulture industry, because horticulture industry, in this the plants are also cultivated, propagated, and they are used for selling at commercial levels for gardening purposes. And the non-commercial uses of genetic resources, because in this the genetic information is used for increasing the scientific knowledge and for understanding the living world. And the non-commercial uses of genetic resources, they are mainly used in the taxonomy and for conservation. In the taxonomy, the information of genetic resources is used to categorize or to group the animals, like from which group or from which species the newly discovered animal or natural resource is belonging. And this will help us to naming those new species or new organisms. And similarly, we can design some conservation methods for the protection of the biodiversity. And mainly this non-commercial use of genetic resources, this work is done by the academic or public research institutes. This is not for the for money. So this was all about the genetic resources, just an introduction of the genetic resources. For more videos on genetic resources and conservation, please subscribe my channel and stay tuned. Bye.